Thank you for watching Chittarupa Yoga and Fitness. I'm Laura Wilson, 200-hour certified yoga teacher. And let's see if we can't just de-stress today. I'm having one of those days. I don't know about you, but this is just a practice to help let all of that go. So let's start with our feet at hip distance, standing nice and tall, weight even on both feet. And let's just begin with a few deep breaths. We're going to inhale through our mouth, nose, and exhale through our mouth. And just see how full we can get our body. Exhale, let it go. And one more really deep breath. I'm going to start with one round. That means three times through of our Nisarga Mukha Bhastrika, which is in detail in another video, but let's go ahead and add it on to here. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Go ahead and step out wide. Start to drop our tail down. Whoops, finding that spot where our knees are over our ankles. And let's just inhale up here. Exhale, bring it down. And maybe you should have pressed back through the hips so that our knees stack up over our ankles. Adding our hip hinge on the next. Big circle sweep of our arms. Now let's find prayer squat, hands at our heart, dropping down, staying high. We're taking it low. Let's take it to some standing cat and cow, just to really warm up the spine. Inhale open, exhale forward. And let's step up to the top edge of our mat. Hands at our heart in prayer. We're going to slide one foot back, straight back, inhale, open up, exhale, stepping forward. Let's move to the other side. Inhale, open, exhale, forward. Flowing with our own breath. Staying tall, shoulders over hips, navel pulling in and up. More each side. Let's go ahead and take it back on that first side, taking our arms and sweeping them up. Nice and strong through the back leg. No bending. Straight and tall. Let's take it back up. Sliding the other foot back again. Nice and tall. Straight through the knee. Let's bring it up, turning sideways on our mat. Let's keep our toes turned in just a bit here. We're going to turn one set of toes out. Let's find warrior two. We're going to go ahead and flow a little bit here. Reverse warrior. Let's inhale here. Exhale, side angle. Inhaling up. Exhaling over. So this is going to be a flowing practice. Let's take it to that reverse warrior and hold. Taking it to our side angle. And let's let's revolve for just a moment. Let's unwind. Come back up, turn the toes forward. Let's turn the other toes out, warrior two, and then reverse warrior. Taking it over to side angle. Let's flow here. Inhale, bring it up. Exhale over. Controlling this through our core, feeling those oblique muscles. Let's hold our reverse warrior. Go ahead and revolve this. On one, and let's come back up. All right, let's step up to the top edge of our mat. We're going to inhale up, exhale, forward fold. Let's step back, hands and knees, pressing back to child's pose. We're going to warm up with some of our push-ups, inhaling forward, exhaling down a little bit, inhaling up, exhaling back. So remember to inhale for the planks, exhale for all the other moves. This is your own practice, so maybe throw in a few push-ups before pressing back, or just stick with the one push-up. We are going to do some sun salutation bees in a moment. And let's go ahead and come forward to our plank. Exhale, lower all the way down. Let's do three cobra breaths here. Inhale the chest up, exhale down. Pressing back to child's pose. We're tucking the toes for our downward facing dog. Remembering, let's lift through the tailbone, shrug the shoulder blades together, push them toward the tailbone, relaxing down through the heels. Let's walk our feet to our hands and bring ourselves up to our mat. Let's step out to the edges of our mat, circle our hips for a moment, get ourselves geared up, switch directions for two sun salutation bees. We've already practiced all the moves that are in it, so let's see what happens. We'll inhale up, exhale, forward fold. We'll start with a right foot slide straight back. Let's come up and we'll hold our lunge for just a moment. So in a moment, we're going to go to child's pose or downward dog. Let's exhale down, step back. Either pose, your choice. So we're going to flow with our breath here. Inhale plank, exhale knees, hips, chest. Inhale chest up, and exhale child's pose or downward dog. Let's bring our right foot forward, finding a lunge. On an exhale, we're going to step up to forward fold. Inhaling with bent knees. Let's hinge up, exhale, sitting the hips back. So let's go to the other side. Inhale up, exhale, forward fold. Sliding the left foot straight back for that lunge. Breathing as deeply as we can. Sun salutations get us really warmed up. So this is a cardio. Should be breathing through our mouth by now. And exhaling down, child's pose or downward dog.
going with our own breath. Inhale plank,
exhale knees, hips, chest.
Inhaling chest up, and exhale child's pose or downward dog.
Slide the left foot forward.
Body or lunge.
Exhaling forward fold. And let's inhale up. Exhale sitting back. And we'll inhale up. Find our mountain. So make sure to get water anytime you feel like you need it. We're going to step back up to the top edge of our mat. Let's slide one foot back, warrior one this time. So our heels are spiraled down. If our balance is okay, our heels are lined up. Our back foot is open to the front corner of our mat, and so is our body, so that we're not torquing out this hip or knee. Taking care of that back leg, having ourselves angled toward the corner while the front foot is toward the front of the mat. Again, strong through both legs. Let's imagine we're going through the act of drawing the feet in toward each other. Notice how that activates those muscles, adds a little lift. Let's lift through the pelvic floor, navel in and up, stacking our spine. And now we'll bring hands to our heart, straighten that front leg. Now we want to think about scissoring this hip forward as we fold forward. This is a good spot for blocks if you have some. Then we're going to lift up spine parallel to the floor. Let our same side hand just land on our leg. Stack our shoulders, triangle, reaching up to the hip or behind. Revolve this, taking the other hand right where that hand is. Other hand as far around behind as we can get. Let's unwind, stacking our shoulders on top of each other again, drawing this hip back. Still staying soft in the knee, a little bit of a bend or a big bend, depending on our body. Now let's come back up, warrior one. So again, angle toward the corner of the mat. Now let's step up. Walk that out. We'll come back to our mountain pose. Sliding our other foot back. And again, front foot towards the front of the mat. Heels lined up if our balance goes for that. Back heel or back toes opened up toward that corner. So is our body. Draw the feet in toward each other. Feel that activation and lift. Gazing off that corner. Now let's bring hands to our heart. This time we'll scissor this hip forward. The other hip comes back. Now let's bow forward, in and out. I'm going to lift our spine up parallel to the floor. Same side hand, wherever it lands on that leg, stack the shoulders. Triangle. We can even open this back foot up a little bit. Now let's go ahead and revolve this pose, bringing this hand down where that one is, other hand all the way around behind, wherever we go. Thank you. coming back up, warrior one, toward the corner. Now let's step up to the top edge of our mat. From here, let's inhale up. Exhale, forward fold. Hands to the floor, let's walk back into our plank. So remember, plank can also be on our knees. And then child's pose or downward dog. Hands and knees, stacking everything. I'm going to show you first a side plank flow from hands and knees, and then I'm going to do it from full plank. But for side plank, what we're going to do is we're going to slide one foot off, inhale that other leg out, up, exhale, come back in, slide the other foot off, inhale, open up, exhale back to all fours. So slide, inhale, exhale, slide, inhale, and exhale. So continue doing that if you prefer to be on your knees. Otherwise, we're going to take it here. Roll the feet, inhale, open. Exhale down, roll the feet, inhale, open. Exhale down. Following our own breath. We'll do one more on each side. Child's pose or downward dog. Let's look at our hands and walk our feet to our hands. Standing forward fold. Inhaling up. Let's exhale to our mountain. So we're going to move to our balance. Get near something, just in case, it always helps, never hurts. Let's take it to our figure four. So crossing one leg over, balancing here, wherever we need our hands. Draw some different stuff. It helps to focus on something that's not moving. We can also start to shift the hips back a little bit. Especially since two places we tend to hold and clench, that is at the shoulders, so we're going to work on those next, and our buttocks. Let's come back up and release. So we're going to look at releasing tension in both the upper shoulders, traps, neck, and in our hips. So let's kind of do a little more opening up here, clapping our hands in front and back. And then we're going to clasp our hands behind us, really drawing the palms together, shrugging the shoulder blades together. So see if we can get those palms to touch, thumbs touch, and then just really focus on opening up through the chest right here. Seeing how deeply we can breathe, opening up the front of our body. If we tend to sit a lot or stand and slump forward, sit and slump forward, this is the perfect pose to do as a little break in the middle of all that, especially the two of you who work in an office. This is a good counter pose to open everything back up. Shake that out. Let's move right onto hips. We're going to turn sideways on the mat so we can step out wide. We're going to start in that prayer squat. High version. We're going to see how low we can go. If necessary, take hands to thighs or even the floor. I'm going to see if I can do it without about any of that. Take it slow. Rock as you need to. Move the feet. This is something I do a lot, so I can kind of get low here. Quite a few people in my classes can as well. But give it a shot. See what you think. Breathing, and then we're just going to release onto the floor. Let's go ahead and start with our legs wide. We're going to hit every aspect of those muscles around our hips. Let's fold forward. So in our deep stretches, we want to focus on our deep breaths. Once we're down here for a couple of minutes, then all that cardio, sun salutation stuff that we did earlier, the arm balances that get our heart rate up, hopefully our heart rate will start to come back down and we can take deeper breaths. Let's come back up and take a side stretch, getting into those oblique muscles that attach down there at the hips, outside of our buttocks. So depending on, you know, where we are today, we have done a lot of heat building moves. We might be able to take this and even touch our toes. So just kind of work to your own body. I'll stay in the middle here. Make sure, however, that it's breathable. We should be able to get a nice regular breath in and out. So we find ourselves kind of struggling, we want to back off to where it's not a struggle anymore. So let's listen to our own body here. We'll bring it back up in the center, reaching up. Let's see how it goes on the other side. They tend to be different. Hips are like that. Again, take it as deep as you want to go. A lot comes into play here, not just the opening of that side body, but the underside of the leg as far as hamstrings. We might find that we want to leave the knee slightly bent if we need to. And let's bring it back up. We're going to bring the legs together and roll on over to our belly. So we're going to see about opening up our chest a little more. Let's start with Sphinx, untucking the toes. Now our purpose here is to unclench the buttocks. Everything from where the top of your pants are down, unclench. Relax, release. It's from above there that we're going to work. Hands under shoulders, shoulder blades to the hips. Let's come forward, elbows underneath shoulders. So again, relaxing from the waist down, keeping our gaze forward, shoulders toward the floor, crown of our head to the sky. So seeing if we can breathe through our belly, feel it pressing into the floor, and then squeezing down. Bringing our hands by our side this time. Everything from waist down, release, and clench. We're going to inhale forward, shrug the shoulder blades together. Imagining that someone has taken hold of our wrists and it's pulling us back. And that's actually, if you've got a partner that you trust, you can actually take turns doing this for each other. It really helps to open and release through the chest and the back. Release and rest. And really opening the chest this time is bringing the hands by our side. We're going to shrug our shoulders together, collapse our hands, and again, just lifting the upper body. Breathing into our belly. And my hands are sweaty. Once again,
Maybe not. Let's go ahead and release from here. We'll press up and have a seat. So let's take the legs out. And we're going to bring one foot in this time. This is going to get a little deeper into those hip muscles as we reach up and over that first leg. So again, just kind of notice how that feels, bending the bottom leg as necessary, staying up a little higher, coming lower, just play around with it. The key is that it's breathable. And just notice, I do notice a little difference in where I feel this stretch when I've got the knee bent, a little bit more up into the lower back, around behind where the hip is here. I feel that a little bit more than when the legs are out long. Let's check in with the other side, see how that side feels. Bring it up and roll on down to the floor. The best way to do that is to take support underneath one knee, tuck the tailbone, and roll back. And I always like to take a little moment here to shake everything out, get oriented to be on the floor. And we're going to find our figure four again, feet to the sky, cross one leg over. We're going to reach straight out for the corresponding thigh, hug the legs in. So the key here is to keep the knee in closer than the foot, feeling that stretch along the hip, down into the leg. Again, breathing deeply. Both feet to the ceiling, hold on to our thighs, open into a V. Bringing the feet together, let's cross the other leg over. Again, reach out for the corresponding thigh, hug in. Take our feet back to the ceiling one more time. Open into that V. And we'll bring the feet down to the floor. Open our arms wide. Let's walk our feet till we feel the edges of our mat. We're going to try a wide leg twist. If our hips don't like this, because we'll feel it across the front side of this one, if it's too intense, just stack the knees on top of each other and twist. Otherwise, stay with this staggered variation. Like I said, we're going to try to get all parts of the hip. So let's see what happens. Slowly, we're just going to go right on over to the other side And remember, each side can be different, so we might need to stack our knees on this side if we didn't on the other, vice versa. So just listening to our own body. Go ahead and draw our knees up, walk the feet in, we'll bring hands down by our side. We're going to come into our final relaxation, which can be the long version we normally do, but since we're looking at releasing through the hips, let's maybe bring the soles of the feet together and knees open. And then arms can be wherever it feels comfortable and relaxing. Again, pick what works for your feet, arms, legs, and go there. Will be different. Once we're in that spot, let's go ahead and relax in our breath. Relax through our hips. Releasing our glutes. Releasing our chest. Relaxing the muscles of our neck and upper back. Giving a little space in our jaw. And just relaxing for a few moments. So feel free to stay here as long as you like. Pause the video. But coming out, we'll wiggle our fingers and toes. Again, moving our arms and legs. Moving our body whatever way it needs. Ultimately, we'll have our knees rolling over to one side. Remember, take your time, especially if you do stay in Shavasana for a while. We always want to come up very slowly. It's kind of like if you were sitting in a chair and you stand up real fast, you wind up falling back in the chair. We don't want to faint from coming up too fast, too soon, or anything like that. So take your time. Let's come to a comfortable seat. And just take a moment to check in with how we're feeling. Let's breathe into our belly. That is the most relaxing breath known to the human body. So as we breathe through our nose, if it's not clogged up, that slows down the rate of our inhales and exhales, which also promotes relaxation in our body. To our heart, drawing all that loving, peaceful energy into our heart. And then we'll take that peace and love and share it with everyone else. Namaste.